y'all. Welcome to another WordPress Wednesday. My name is Corey Ashton here at WebTegrity in San Antonio, Texas. And this is a show every single week that I get to nerd out with you on all things WordPress. So today, I know that this topic is something that I talk about quite often. And if you're doing a Google search and watching this video, it's probably because you've questioned yourself about this very often. And you should be. So the question is, when should I update WordPress? And a more important question is, how should I update my WordPress website? So I talk about this. I've done other tutorials step by step on exactly how to do this. Some people have asked, should I update my plugins first, then update my core? Should I ever update my theme? How do I deal with a child theme? There are so many questions when it comes to the frustrating moment of, what do I do when I have a little icon on my desktop, or on my dashboard rather, that says I have an update due? All right, you guys, this is it. I'm gonna walk you just briefly through what it looks like to update. I'm getting ready to update to 4.4, all right? And this is a live working website that I'm getting ready to do this on. When should I update? So there are questions specifically about, when should I update my core? When should I update a plugin? And to that question, I want to say, you always want to be actively updating. Does that mean that you should update the exact moment, the exact day that an update is released? Not necessarily. And one of my reasonings behind that is, sometimes there are little glitches that haven't been caught yet. And once they roll out an update and they blast it out, and let's say 10,000 people update their plugin or update their theme, and unfortunately the bug is finally caught at that point, and then they quickly release another update, and you're gonna have to go update again. So what I want you to do is look at the reasoning behind the update. If you get an opportunity, go to the developer's website that talks about what sort of fixes they have made in this particular update. And this is specifically talking about a theme, specifically talking about a plugin. You'll want to just go take a look and see if it was in fact a security update, that there's something that's happened. Maybe there's some sort of a robot out there that is specifically targeting a certain plugin, and they have found the breach and they have locked it down and released a secure update that requires that you very quickly go update your plugin. If that is the scenario, I suggest you immediately update your plugin, all right? You obviously want to be sure that you have a backup of your entire website in place. You can do that through your hosting company. You can also do that through a plugin. And I will put a link right here, actually, to another video that I've done on how to back up your WordPress website. You always want to be sure that you have a backup in place, and that backup needs to be the moment before you click update. So you want to be sure that you have a very recent backup. You don't want it to be a backup from 30 days ago, because you might have made some changes that you've forgotten about. So be sure that you have a recent backup. Be sure that you understand how to implement that backup. If you were to click update right now and all of a sudden things break, you get the white screen of death. What can you do to very quickly set your website back so that nobody sees that break happen? You'll want to connect with your hosting company if you're relying on them to make those backups. You'll want to see if they have something like a one-click restore option, or if they're going to charge you to roll your website back and reset it back to a prior version. Please be sure that you understand that what I'm saying right now, and that you have a very tangible, a very easy step-by-step plan in place to do that if and when the occasion arises, okay? If you have a backup in place, if you know how to do a restore, then go ahead and do your updates. And again, I've already done a video that kind of walks you through how I suggest you do your updates, and I'll put that link in the description box below for you. This particular update that I'm dealing with right now is updating my WordPress core. As you all know, themes require updates, plugins require updates, and your core requires updates, which is WordPress itself. Now, when WordPress releases an update, I very, very rarely go the first day and click update. I typically wait to see what the response is around the WordPress world, and we're seeing a couple of glitches right now in 4.4. We're seeing a couple of alerts with people using SSLs on their website, secure server layers, security tied into their website. We're seeing some sort of issues of images breaking, some sort of issues of other things kind of conflicting. So this is one of the reasons why I hesitate. So it's been a few days now. It's actually been almost over a week, and they've already kind of done some things that they're going to be rolling out soon to kind of upgrade and to speak to some of those issues, some of those glitches that we're seeing. But because we haven't seen massive issues, we haven't seen a whole lot of people complaining about major things, then now I'm ready. I would have, of course, updated immediately if had this been a security breach. And really great hosting companies will actually push your update through automatically, bypassing you if it is, in fact, a security breach. So I want you to be sure you see my alert here because I host with WP Engine. It's saying, before updating, please back up your database and files. It's two different things that you have to back up. WP Engine allows me to do that with just one click. I know for a fact that I have an update in place. I've already done that process. If you do not have a hosting company that automatically does that for you, there is a link to WordPress Codecs that will help you better understand how to do updates. And of course, like I mentioned earlier, I've got another video in the description box below that'll walk you through how to use a free plugin to have backups in place. Once you know you have that, you can go ahead and click update now. Again, WP Engine gives me a very quick heads up. Hey, are you sure you want to do this? Do you already have a backup or a restore point in place? Yes, I do. I'm going to go ahead and click refresh, or I'm sorry, update. So while that's processing through, there are a few things you need to do immediately following you clicking that button. My browser is restoring right now. So now that that's done, it shows you right away that WordPress updated successfully. Fantastic. Now as I go into, if you wanted to, you could stay here on the dashboard and kind of see what's new in 4.4. And one of the most obvious things that's going to be here now is 2016, the latest theme coming out for 2016. It talks you through all the different new features of 2016. And it also talks about the changes that came out here in Clifford, which is the 4.4. You can watch this video and better understand the different things that were done with 4.4's upgrade. However, the other thing you want to do is go immediately to the front side of your website. You want to go through this whole thing and make sure that everything is still working. You want to do a hard refresh, clearing your cache completely and making sure that you're seeing your website in the most recent version. You'll want to check it on a device and make sure that everything on your cell phone reads correctly. You'll want to go look at it on a different browser and make sure, again, everything kind of looks correctly. If you're using major plugins, for instance, on our classes page, we're using a major plugin to highlight our classes. So I want to make sure that that plugin is still working and nothing looks wonky or broken. So you'll want to look at all that. You'll want to make sure, of course, that your major point of contact, your CTA, your call to action is still in place, whether that's a phone number or whether that's an email form. You'll want to be sure that all that is functioning properly still. So those are just a couple of things that you want to do as soon as you do an update. So when should you update? If it's a security breach, immediately. How should you update? You always want to have a backup in place first, and then walk through. You want to walk through the step-by-step instructions that I'll put in another video that I've done for you. And you know what? I'm going to put it right here for you. Click on this. Go see how to step-by-step do all of your updates. I hope you're having a great WordPress Wednesday. Be sure to subscribe to our channel. Send us some love over on Facebook or send us a tweet, and we'll try to do a video tutorial for you on the next WordPress Wednesday. Y'all have a great one. Bye, y'all.